So let's continue on numerical methods. Yeah, we are still here in our session on random number generation. So we started with looking at the inversion of the distribution function. So that is the section on random number generation, and we had the method inversion of the distribution function. Actually, we already saw two nice examples, normal distributed random variable, exponential distributed random variable. Of course, the broader context is that we like to generate a sequence of random number. The broader context is that we like to generate a sequence sampling from a random variable that is not uniform, so has some other distribution. And we already had the observation that the normal distribution, for example, doesn't have a distribution function where we can apply our nice method inversion of the distribution function. So actually that is solved because we have good approximations. But now comes the method, which is very interesting, which doesn't require that we can invert the distribution function. So the following method generates an F-distributed drawing, Xi. So given that we know, and this sounds a little bit strange, a G-distributed drawing, Yi, and we have some mean to check a condition, namely that the density g prime, yeah, derivative of the distribution function is the density, multiplied with the constant is larger than the density of the f distributed random variable, yeah, so f prime for some constant. So that's a strange setup. So what is going on here? So our aim is we like to generate Xi being F distributed. We do not know F, or maybe more specifically F inverse, because if we would know F inverse, yeah, we would already have a nice method. But we know the density. And normal distribution is an example. So maybe I write this here. So normal distribution is an example for all this. So we know the density, yeah. So little phi of x is some constant, yeah, 1 divided by square root of 2p. So some constant time e to the minus x square half, okay? So we know an analytic formula. So this is the situation. We like to generate an f-distributed sequence. We do not know f, or more importantly, we do not know F inverse, but we know the density. And in addition, we know another sequence. So we know how to generate, say, a sequence Yi, which is G distributed, for some G that has the property that the density of this distribution G, so G prime, is larger than the density of F. Well, the integral of the density has to be 1, yeah? So there may be regions where it is larger, but then there is maybe also another region where it is smaller. So it is sufficient to actually just have this when I increase a little bit the G by using a constant, I multiply with a constant. So I have here this condition. And in this situation, I can generate Xi. And from a mathematical point of view, I can generate it precisely. Yeah. So there's no approximation. Yeah? Of course, for the normal distribution also, yeah, from a mathematical point, I do not have an analytic formula, but from a computer implementation point, I have an exact implementation. So this is here the little lemma. Yeah? So the acceptance rejections sampling. So why it has this name will be clear when we have understood how it works. So the aim is to generate an F-distributed random variable, and given R drawings UJ YJ from a random variable UY, where U is a uniform distributed random variable. So that was not on my previous slide, but we already know how to generate uniforms. And Y is a G distributed random variable. So in other terms, I have this sequence YJ that has G distribution, and I need another sequence UJ that has uniform distributions as a little helper. Then let F denote the density. So little f is the density, so it is the derivative of the distribution function associated with my random variable x. So I would like to sample x. So let's call the f distributed guy x. So here is x, which will then have distribution function f. So I have the density little f, and I also have the density for the g distributed random variable, which I call y. And I assume there exists a constant c, c larger than zero. Actually, c is larger than one, yeah, which we can show, but I assumed that there exists a constant c larger than zero. Actually, c is larger than equal one. Yeah, it could be equal one, such that we have these conditions. So for all x, the density f is smaller or equal c times the density g. So let's draw a little picture to get an intuition. Yeah, intuition is always important. So how does this look like? So this here is my density. So I need the density f. So let's assume the density f is somewhere here. So maybe it looks a little bit like a normal distribution. Okay, so this here is my density f. Now I know that there is a density g. Maybe the density g looks like that. So it's higher here. Okay, higher here. Maybe here it's not as high as it should be. And it goes like that. Okay, but then I can find a constant c. So this here is my density g. But then I can find a constant c such that c times g is larger. Okay, so this guy here is c times g. So I can shift it a little bit and it becomes larger. If I am in this situation, yeah, so I know another distribution where the density allows to get dominating the density, yeah, so c times the density can dominate the other density, then I have a very nice method. An example is really the normal distribution. The normal distribution has e to the minus x squared, but e to the minus x is the exponential distribution, the other guy we had in the previous session. And there is a constant such that e to the minus x is larger than e to the minus x squared. So because it's just the exponential decay, yeah, for in the direction of minus and plus infinity, yeah, where actually normal distribution decays faster. So I can find this constant. And for the exponential distribution, I have an analytic formula for the distribution function. So I can generate this sequence exactly with the inversion. So now I have described the situation. How does the method works? Okay, so it claims that here the sequence xi defined by yki this sequence is f-distributed. So xi is y ki. So ki is an index, so it's defined here. So what does this mean? So this means we are using only selected elements of the sequence y. Yeah? So some are accepted, some are rejected. Yeah? So that's the reason why the method is called acceptance rejection. So we apply some kind of filter to the sequence y. And the filter is very specific rule, a very specific condition. And after you have filtered out some elements according to this rule, the remaining sequence has f distribution. So what's this filter? So what is here defining the filtering? So this filter is the condition is uj smaller or equal f of yj divided by c times g of yj. So according to our condition, the stuff on the right-hand side is smaller than one. So according to our condition, this stuff here is between 0 and 1. Okay, because f is smaller than, less or equal than c times g. And of course, this here is a uniform distributed random variable. Yeah, so it is a random variable. I sample a random variable uniform. It is a random variable between 0 and 1. And then I'm checking, is it smaller than f of y divided by c g of y? And f of y divided by c g of y used for y equal yj. So for the corresponding thing. So you see that the filtering is actually random. Yeah. So I'm not filtering all guys that are larger than 5, yeah, or 0.5, because that would be stupid. Yeah, my sequence would be between 0 and 0.5. So actually I'm drawing a random variable uj, and then I'm checking, is this below if I evaluate this ratio of the density. So sometimes a value is rejected and sometimes the same value is accepted. Yeah? So the criteria to filter it is stochastic itself, and the stochasticity of this filtering is given by this additional sequence u. Yeah, so I need a two-dimensional sequence, and then I have this filtering and I get a one-dimensional sequence. So I just need to check this condition. So here it looks a little bit complicated because I'm here telling you explicitly the index that I take. But if you look at the definition, how this index is defined, it is just the index ki is the next index. So the smallest j larger than ki minus 1. So the next index where the condition is true. And I start with k0 in 0, so let's just take the first index where the condition is true. So I hope you now know how we have to read this. If we draw a small picture, this is really a simple thing, yeah? So the algorithm is to generate samples of X using here acceptance rejection. We first generate pairs Y, U. So maybe let me just write this pair. So I use here my sequence U, J. So I generate here samples of the sequence U, J. This is a uniform sequence. Then I also generate the sequence yj. This is my g distributed. Then I'm checking the condition. Yeah, so I'm taking the two values here. So this value and that value. I'm checking the condition. So the condition is uj less or equal f of yj divided by c of g, c times g of yj. So I'm checking the condition. And if the condition is, say, true, I'm using the point. Okay, so, and this point is now my, so what color did I use? I used green. Okay, so that, and this point here is now my xk, yeah? So it has a different indexing because it may sometimes happen. So you check again here the condition, and maybe here the condition is false. So you don't take the point. And here again, you check the condition. And maybe here the condition is also false. So you don't take the point. And here you check the condition. And maybe here the condition is true. Yeah, so you take the point, yeah? So here I took 2 out of 4 points and it goes on. Oops, I always used red here. And maybe it happens here that we accept also a little bit more often the points. And this is now an F-distributed sequence. So that's the claim. Okay, so interesting method. So some stochastic filtering of the sequence. First thing we should look when we should test what is actually the probability to accept a point. Yeah, so we are not accepting all points. So the probability to accept a point . This is the probability that the random variable u is less or equal f applied to the random variable y, so that is not a capital Y, divided by c times g applied to the random variable y. Okay, so if I write this like this, so it is the probability of the set of all omegas where this condition holds. So u of omega is less or equal f of y of omega divided by g of y of c times g of y of omega. So this is the probability that we accept a point. And you see sometimes here in this example, yeah, so we are maybe not so often accepting a point. Yeah, this is also relevant for the efficiency of the method, yeah, that we have a high probability to accept a point because then we get out many points, yeah, of our calculation. So to prove this, let me first note that the probability to accept a point, so that was here from the previous slide, is actually just 1 divided by c. So I mentioned that c is larger than 1. So, but I do not like to make this constant too large. Yeah? So I would like to make this constant c as small as possible to accept many points. So why is that? So, well, a little issue here is that in this probability, I have a random variable here and I have a random variable here. Yeah? Otherwise, I could just take the distribution function maybe and I already know the probability. But here I have a uniform guy. So this looks a little bit like a distribution function, probability that the random variable is below something. But the something on the right-hand side is a random variable itself. But you can get rid of this issue by factoring out, yeah, the random variable on the right-hand side. So I'm looking to the conditional probability, conditional that y has a certain value, little y. So the probability that the random variable u is below f of y divided by z times g of y, conditional to the random variable y having a certain value is of course just the probability that u is below this constant where I use y for the random variable y. I know that u is a uniform distributed random variable. So remember in one of our last sessions, we had that the distribution function of the uniform distributed random variable is the identity. So I have that the conditional probability to accept the point, conditional that y is equal to little y, this is just this ratio of the densities. So the ratio of the densities is the probability to accept the point, given that the point is a little y. So now the probability that we accept any point, so if we have here the random variable y, I can write this as the probability to accept a specific point multiplied with the density that this point occurs, integrated over all possible values of the points that we can have for y. So I can use here this conditional probability inside the integral, and I'm integrating, so I'm what I did is under the integral, I factored out the conditional probability, so and then I can integrate over the density. Okay, so now I can plug in this guy, so I know that this guy here is just this ratio of the distribution functions. So I have that under the integral, there's f of y divided by c times g of y multiplied with g of y. So this is then just f of y divided by c. So it's just f of y divided by c. Integrating the density f is equal to 1. So this is just 1 divided by c. Okay, very nice little intermediate result. So we know the probability to accept a point is 1 divided by c. So I really like to have c small, but c is a constant which I need to dominate the other density. Yeah. So be parsimonious, do not be too wasteful choosing the c. So now let's prove the theorem that the stuff which we filtered out is actually f distributed. So that's the whole proof. Of course, I use again here some simple results. So I will use that the conditional probability, so the probability A conditional B is the probability A intersected B divided by the probability B, yeah, so renormalized with the probability B. And I will also, of course, use the fact that if I have in a conditional probability two random variables, yeah, then I can factor this out, yeah, by saying that one random variable should be equal some value. So the trick that we did here, one random variable should be equal some value, and then integrate over all possible values that could occur. So these are the two ingredients. So I use now this relation with the conditional probability P A conditional B is P A intersected B divided by P B, with A equals Y is less than X. And B is our filtering criteria. So B is that we accept the point. Okay, why is that? Because that is exactly what I need for the distribution function. So the distribution function of X is the probability that X is less or equal little x. So this is the definition of the distribution function. So I would like to investigate this. So when is x less or equal little x? So I know that x is equal to y when I accept the point. So actually this is the probability that y is less or equal x under the condition that I have accepted the point. So I can write my distribution function of f as a conditional probability, the probability that y is smaller than x under the condition that we have accepted the point. So now I use this guy that the conditional probability is just the ratio of the event intersected with the condition divided by the probability of the condition. So it's just the ratio of the probability of the event intersected with the condition divided by the probability of the condition. The probability of the condition is already known. So the probability of the condition is this here, and we have already calculated this. So this was on the previous slide. So this is equal to 1 divided by C. Yeah. So my condition is I accept the point. The probability to accept the point is 1 divided by C. So you see that this C will move here in front. Yeah. So I have C times the probability of this intersection. So the probability that y is smaller or equal x intersected with I accept the point. So now I have also again two random variables here. So I have here the random variable y. Oops, I used the other color. So I have here the random variable y inside. And I have here the random variable u inside. So I rewrite this again as a conditional probability. So the probability that y is equal to z. So I use here y is equal to z multiplied with the density of y, g of z dz. Okay, so I can write this as the integral of is z smaller or equal x, yeah? So y is now equal to z. So is z, little z, smaller or equal to x, intersected with u is smaller or equal f of z divided by c times g of z. So the probability of this event of all omegas where this holds multiplied with g of z. The first thing is that we note that here the condition that z, which color should I use? Maybe I use here this one. This condition z should be smaller than x while we are integrating over all z is actually just the same as leaving the condition out and let the integral run up to x. Okay, so in the next step, I can get rid of this part of this intersection by just integrating up to x. And you see what you have here under the integral. So if you remove this guy, it's just the probability that capital U is less than f of z divided by c times g of z. So I can use again the fact that U is uniform. So the probability that U is less or equal F of Z divided C, G of Z. This is just distribution function is the identity F of Z divided by C, G of Z. So I get this guy out here. And you see the G cancels. I just integrate over f of z, but note I integrate here up to x. So it's the integral of the derivative of the distribution function up to x. It's just f of x, and the c also cancels. Yeah, the c also cancels. Okay, and we have that the distribution function is indeed f of x. So we started by looking at this expression, and we wanted to prove that this is f. So indeed, x is f distributed. So generating the sequence y and stochastically, yeah, so randomly filtering it by this helper sequence u will give us a sequence that has distribution f. So that was the presentation of the acceptance rejection method. And we can have maybe nice examples how you can use this for exponential distributions that are, well, inhomogeneous, and for example, for the normal distribution. And maybe we do this in the next session. So that was it for today. Thank you.